Let's talk about what's called the point-slope form of the equation of a line. Now, to use the point-slope form, you're going to need a point, and you're going to need the slope of the line. So let's take an example here. I'm given a point on my line. Here's the point, 1, 2. And I'm also given the slope of the line. It's 3. Now recall that slope is often denoted with an m. Okay, so let's make an observation. If I have another point here, and I'm going to label that second point as x, y. Okay. Now remember, the slope is always a relationship between two points. And what I mean by that is that you can use two points to get the slope. So how do I do that? Well, I'm going to take y subtract 2. So I get, let's see, y minus 2. And I'm going to divide that by, right? So y take away 2 divided by x take away 1, that's how you find the slope of a line, right? So this coordinate take away that one divided by this coordinate take away that one has to be equal to the slope of the line. That's got to be equal to positive 3. That's always the relationship between two points in the line, is that if you create the fraction by taking the difference of their coordinates, you have to get the slope. Now this equation here, I can, if I want, I can multiply both sides by the denominator, which is x minus 1. So I'm going to clear denominators. So here we go, x minus 1 on the left and x minus 1 on the right. And when I do that, well, the x minus 1s are going to cancel. That's why we did it. And on the left, I just have this y minus 2. So it's y minus 2 equals, well, 3 times x minus 1. Okay, this is the equation of a line. Now, what that's telling you is that any point that's on the line xy has to satisfy this equation. This equation is in a special form. It's called the point-slope form. So you're looking at the point-slope form of the equation of a line right now. Now, you can see why, when you look at this line, why it's called the point-slope form. Do you see where the coordinates of the point and where the slope, where they go in this equation? Well, yeah, the y-coordinate, right, the 2, goes right here, so it's y take away the y-coordinate, and then that's equal to the slope, right, there goes your 3 right there, times x take away the x-coordinate, which is 1. Now, I created the point-slope form for this particular line, but if I wanted to play that game generally, well, what do I do? Let's do that down here. I'm going to need a point, and I'm going to need the slope. So let's say that you had a point right here, and I don't want to label this point with specific numbers. I want to say, hey, let's say the coordinates were x1, y1. Okay, I'm not committing to numbers here, but I am telling you that these are the coordinates of that point. And let's say you're also given the slope, just call it m. Now, we could do what we just did a moment ago in the previous line. That is, you could say, let's say I wanted to find the coordinates of another point on that line. And let's say I denoted that other point as just x, y. Now, first of all, you have to distinguish between these two points. X, y stands for any point on the line. Okay, so x, y is real general. X1, y1 refers to this specific point. So when I go to create my point slope form, let's use this as a guide. What does it say to do? Well, it's going to be y, referring to this y, right, the general y. So it's going to be y take away the y coordinate of the point you have on the line. That's this point. So it's y take away y1, right, the point that you're given, is equal to what? Well, your slope multiplied by x take away the x-coordinate of the point you're given, which is x1. So this is the general point-slope form. Of the equation of our line. Now, whenever you use this form, all you have to do is you have to fill in the y1, you've got to fill in the m, and you have to fill in the x1. The x here and the y there, those don't change. They remain x and y when you're finished. Okay? So this is our point-slope form. Let's gain some practice using that now. So remember, we're going to use this whenever we're given the point on the line and the slope. Let's try an example. Okay, find the equation in point-slope form of the line through the point 2, negative 5 with slope equals 1 third. Okay, so what is point-slope form? Well, it's this. Y minus y sub 1 equals m times x minus x sub 1. Now remember, you have to fill in the y sub 1, the m, and the x sub 1. And y sub 1 is the point, the y-coordinate of the point you're given. What would that be? Well, here's the point we're given. There's the y-coordinate, which is negative 5. You have to be a little careful here because this says y take away the y-coordinate. Now, if you want to do y take away a negative, you have to write this. Y take away the negative 5, right? So this subtraction is inherited, and if we're subtracting a negative, we have to put that negative number in parentheses. And then m is our slope, which is 1 third. And then we're left with x take away the x-coordinate of the point we're given, which is 2. And that's your answer. You don't have to go any further. That's the point-slope form of the equation of our line. Now, I know part of you probably wants to write this as y plus 5, and that's okay. But you should know that technically you don't have to go any further with these problems. Okay, let's try another one like that. Okay, use the point-slope form to write the equation of the line passing through this point with slope equals negative 4. Write the equation in slope-intercept form. Okay, now they tell us to start with the point-slope form, but to end in the slope-intercept form. Okay, let's take one thing at a time. Use the point-slope form. Okay, no problem. That's y minus y1 equals m times x minus x sub 1. Okay, so let's see the y-coordinate of the point we're given. Well, that's 2. So this y doesn't change, remember. So it's y take away 2 equals the slope, which is negative 4. Okay, now, usually you write this parenthesis down right away, but sometimes you have to be careful, and here's why. I'm going to replace the x-coordinate of the point I'm given, but it's a negative 3. So this is going to become x take away negative 3. And you know I'm going to use parentheses right there, right? Which means I'm going to change these to brackets. So it's going to be x take away, here we go, the x coordinate, which is negative 3. Sometimes you have to look a little bit ahead like that. Okay, now this wouldn't be the end of the problem because look what they say. Write the equation in slope-intercept form. Now remember, slope-intercept form, that's this, y equals mx plus b. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this equation and simplify it and get y by itself. No problem. So y minus 2 equals negative 4. Okay, x minus negative 3, that's going to be x plus 3. I'm going to change these back to parentheses. It still denotes multiplication though, right? So then it's going to be y minus 2 equals, take this negative 4 and distribute it. So negative 4x and negative 4 times positive 3 is negative 12. And then finally, we're going to add 2 to both sides. And we get y is equal to negative 4x minus 10. Okay, and this would be my answer. This is the equation of the line in slope-intercept form. Okay, so we actually have three forms of equations of lines. We have slope-intercept form, point-slope form, and there's yet another form called standard form, which we'll talk about in another video. Until next time.